Already, just the recap of your 11 and 12 physics, math, all those topics. So, is there any problem? Because yesterday I didn't have the time to discuss whether you have any problem or not. Okay, and please remember that we have very little time. Okay, almost 3 months. In between that 3 months, we have to complete our syllabus. Okay, so if you have any query, put that in the WhatsApp group. You can text me anytime. Okay, because we have only 1 hour class. Okay, so it may not be possible every day to solve your query or solve the numericals. Okay, so I am trying my best to solve all those numericals for your help, okay? But if you have any query, any problem regarding the topics I am discussing here in the class, let me know, okay? Okay, regarding the previous class, just let me ask you one question. It was very basic question actually. Just a minute. Let's see whether you can solve this or not. Okay, is this screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, any... Just give me one response, okay, that it's visible. No need to respond. Give the response of the whole class, okay? Okay, one just basic thing I need to know. You can see this, for this inductor, I am writing this equation, V equals to L di dt, right? So, according to the Faraday's law and Lenz's law, that we read in 11-12 physics in electromagnetics, there we saw,
so we cannot see anything, sir, on the screen.
Okay, okay,
just so what you are writing, wait. It is not visible.
Okay, okay, just wait, just wait. Okay, now is this screen visible? This,
yes, sir.
PDF? Okay, so you can see this equation V equals to L di dt, right? You can see this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so according to Lenz's law, what does the Lenz's law state? According to that statement, it opposes the very own cause, right? And according to that, we should write V equals to L di dt with negative sign. But here, I wrote only L di dt. So, okay, is this clear now? Is this clear now to everyone?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, here, why this negative sign is not given? Here, negative sign must be there, na? because it is opposing the very much cause. But I haven't written the negative sign. So why? That is my question. Okay, if you know, speak. See, I haven't started yet the class. The class will start from 3:10. Okay, that is just some question that may be asked in your interview based on this basic electrical. Because since it is in your syllabus, so in interview they may ask. Okay, so why this negative sign is not given? Can you answer this question?
So can I?
Yes, yes, you may.
So as in acceleration and deceleration, in deceleration minus sign is given. So as in this, if the opposes the flow of current or resist it, then there is a minus, there is not a minus sign. If it doesn't oppose, then there should be a minus sign.
But it is opposing now. Because what is the main statement of Lenz's law and Faraday's law? Faraday's law states that one voltage will be developed. And Lenz's law states that if this voltage is developed and it opposes the rate of change of current, opposes the voltage with the rate of change of current. That's why this minus sign is present. But I haven't written here. And one more thing, here acceleration or deceleration concept is not that good.
That, okay. That is just for reference, sir. That is just for reference.
Okay. No, that is, okay. Let me tell you that. This is the inductor. Okay. What is inductor? Have you seen a spring that is inside the ball pen? Some pins are there in front of that nib. Some springs are there. The inductor just like that spring. Okay, it looks like that spring. When we are trying to flow the current through this spring, one voltage will be developed in opposite direction. Okay, since this is the direction of the voltage, VL. Okay, and the current is flowing in this direction. Since current is flowing in this direction, so our voltage is, this one is positive, this one is negative, right? But the voltage developed across the inductor is just the opposite. Okay, so that's why we always wrote V. This is the voltage across the battery, okay? Equals to minus of VL. Okay, clear? So, what is the value of VL? That is minus of L di dt. So, ultimately, you are getting the equation L di dt. Okay, is it clear to everyone? Concept clear hua?
Yes, sir.
Concept. Why this? According to our level 12 physics concept, we have a negative sign. But here we are not writing here. Why? Because of this concept. Okay. Fine. So it's almost 3:10. Okay. Let me check whether anyone is there or not.
Sir, can you explain it once again?
Okay. One inductor is connected just like the resistor. And since this one is a passive element and bilateral element, so whether whatever be its point, whether I am connecting like AB or BA, it doesn't matter because current can flow in either way. Clear? So I have connected one battery here. And the current is flowing I, right? And due to that current flow, one voltage will be developed across the inductor and that voltage is in opposite direction. That's why this negative sign is there according to Lenz's law, correct?
Yes, sir.
So, if I develop the equation of this loop, of this circuit, then what is this
source voltage. Okay, some noises are coming. Please mute yourself when you are not speaking. Okay, thank you. So this is your source voltage, this is your loss. So according to our theory, whatever be the source must be equal to our output. This is our input, this one is our input, this one is our output. Okay, so V equals to minus of VL. Why? Because VL direction is opposite. If the current is flowing like this, I, okay, this side will be positive, this one negative. If direction changes, this one positive, this one negative. Okay, so V equals to minus VL. Why minus VL? Because its direction is opposite to the source. Clear? Now minus VL, what is the value of VL? That is minus of LdI dt. So minus minus, it will be plus. So our total equation become this V equals to LdI dt. That's why this equation is here. Okay, clear?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, fine. So from this equation, we can generate this integrated form where we can develop the current also. If the voltage is known to us, we can develop the current equation. Okay. And what is our basic knowledge of power? Power equals to voltage into current. Correct. Here voltage is LdI dt and current is normally I. So LdI dt into I. This is our power equation. Now, what about this capacitor? Okay, we in previous class we stopped up to this. Okay, so from today we are starting from this capacitor portion. What equation is known to us for capacitor? Q equals to CV, right? Yaad aaya? Q equals to CV ek equation tha jab capacitor.
Yes, sir.
Very good. So what is Q? Q equals to current into time, right? Q equals to current
IT
into
yes.
time. Correct. IT equals to CV. That is not capital T. Okay. Capital T means your stream, information technology. Okay. So this is your small t, right? Now, if we write this equation in derivative form, that means if incremental change is there, what is the incremental change? That means if we are spending time from T1 to T2, then what is our change? That change is called increment. Okay, incremental change. And from that concept, that derivation, integration terms are coming. Okay, so here we are writing like I into dt, okay, because time is changing, but current flow across the capacitor must be constant and capacitor value is also constant. Okay, C into dv, because voltage is changing across the capacitor. And always remember, across the inductor, when current is flowing, inductor stores energy in the form of magnetic energy, right? And capacitor stores in the form of electrical energy. Okay, this may be given in MCQ question. Okay, so I dt equals to C dv. So we can write here as I equals to C into dv dt. So from this basic equation, this equation is derived. That this is called the incremental change. dv. dv means what? Incremental change in voltage with respect to time. What is the dt? Incremental change in time. Okay, now what is the value of power? Power equals to V into I. I value is already known to you, C into dv dt. So that's why only V is written here. Okay, concept clear hua sabka?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay.
Yeah.
So some simple numericals that we are going to solve now. 100 ohm resistance directly switched on across a 10 volt battery. What is the current through the resistor? That is very simple question. Okay. V by R. So 0.1 ampere. And remember, whether this simple question is given or some hard question is given, always draw the circuit diagram. Okay. Because it may happen that you may not solve just by looking at this equation. If you try to draw the circuit diagram, then many complex equation becomes easy. Okay. So what is the circuit diagram here? 100 ohm resistance. This is your resistance and one battery is connected here. Okay, just see this simple circuit diagram. So this will give you full marks in this question. Okay, so I equals to V by R, that is 0.1 ampere, very easy. Now what is the energy consumed? How to calculate energy consumed means according to Joule's law, I square RT. Right, very good. So I square RT, I value is known to you, R value is known to you, T value is already given, 5 seconds. So 5 joule. Okay, very simple question. Now, next, the strength of the current in 1 Henry inductor changes at a rate of 1 ampere per second. Okay, find the voltage across it and determine the magnitude of energy stored in the inductor after 2 seconds. So, here L value is given, that is 1 Henry. Okay, here circuit diagram is not drawn, so you have to draw it. Okay, next, at a rate of 1 ampere per second, what is the meaning of rate of 1 ampere per second? Normal unit of current is ampere. Here rate means the incremental change of current, that is 1 ampere per second. That means di by dt value is 1, that is written here. Okay, what is the voltage across the inductor? That is L di dt, 1 volt. Clear? What is the energy stored? Total energy stored equation is half Li squared. Now, can anyone say, can anyone tell me how this equation is here? How I am writing this half Li squared? Is it right?
Energy stored in capacitor?
No.
Energy stored in inductor.
Yes. How this is correct? But energy stored in the inductor is L di dt. Okay. So how this equation I am getting? Okay, is my question clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this
sir.
Is okay. So let me tell you.
Sir,
this
magnetic
is your,
field, sir.
Yes, that is magnetic energy. Inductor is storing its energy in the form of magnetic field. But we have to calculate that energy. Okay. So here P is your power, and if we multiply power with time, that is nothing but energy, right? So I am writing here P into dt equal to L into di into I. Okay, now integrate both sides, right? So what is P into dt? With integration, maybe from 0 to t or t to t1 to t2, it is nothing but the energy stored. I am writing it as W. L, it is constant. Integration I into di. So what is the integration of I di? Half into I squared. Okay. So this is the way how we get the energy stored value as half Li squared. Okay, simple way, just like that. Energy stored in the capacitor. What is the formula for power stored in the capacitor? C V dv dt, correct? What is P into dt? That is the power stored equals to C V dv. Okay, integrate both sides, you will get, okay, I am writing here WL because it is across the inductor. I am WC. Writing here as C. So it will be half CV square. Okay, this equation you already know, but you don't know how to derive this. So this is the process how you derive. Okay, clear? So just using this formula, do this numerical. The capacitor has a capacitance of 5 microfarad. Microfarad means 10 to the power minus 6 farad. Okay. Next, calculate the stored energy in it. If a DC voltage 100 volt is applied across, if the voltage is known to you, capacitor value is known to you. So put the value, you will get the answer. Okay. Very simple question. Now, next, these are the questions for you. Okay. What will happen if the inductor, to the inductor, if a DC volt, 10 volt DC is applied to it? Second, what types of energy stored in the inductor and capacitor? This one already I had discussed. Next, the current and voltage profile of an element versus time has been given in the figure. Now, what is the element and what is the value? Okay, you have to find out. Now, can you tell me the first question? If you know the answer, or whatever be right or wrong answer, can you tell me? If 10 volt DC is applied across the inductor, what will happen? Okay, anyone? Okay, whether you know or not, just give one response. Hello, am I audible to you?
No, sir.
Okay, I am not audible to you. Or
audible, you can... yes, sir, but
okay. Okay, fine. So, what is the equation of the inductor? V equals to L into di dt. Correct. This is the equation. Right? Now, 10 volt I already had applied. So, 10 volt I am applying. L value something, L value is not given here. It doesn't matter at all. Now, what is di by dt? Di by dt means the incremental change in current. That means with respect to time, current is changing. Okay. Now, if you apply the 10 volt DC, is there any chance that current is changing from 1 second to second or third second? Is there any chance?
No, sir.
Okay, that means their rate of change of current is zero, right? So your di by dt value is zero. So what will happen in the inductor? The inductor will act like a short circuit because there is no chance that inductor can store the energy. Okay, clear? If you apply the inductor across a DC voltage, then that inductor will act as a short circuit. Okay, clear? Now, what are the types of energy stored in the inductor? That is already I had discussed. Okay, and for capacitor also I had discussed. In case of inductor, in the form of magnetic energy. In case of capacitor, in the form of electrical energy. Okay, so we are moving to the second one. Now, here we will learn about the types of sources. Next, what is the concept of AC and DC? Next, the type of connection with resistor, inductor and capacitor, and numericals based on it. Okay. So, these are the numericals that you have to solve first. In next class, I will show you. Okay. Now, total various types of sources are there according to their usage. Okay, if we are applying the voltage across one element, then it is called voltage source. If we want to flow current, then it is called current source. So total two types of sources are there, voltage source and current source. Okay, in circuit diagram we are drawing these sources like the it is shown here. Okay, VAB shown here, plus and minus, and we also can draw the VAB like this. One circle, the upper one positive, second lower one negative. Okay, next the current source. Current source only arrow mark is given. Okay, also two double circle coinciding, this also symbolize the current source. Okay, now according to the change in magnitude and direction, two types of sources are there, AC source and DC source. Okay, AC means alternating current, its magnitudes are changing time to time, angle is magnitude is changing time to time based on the angle. And for DC voltage source, the voltage or current source, it is constant throughout the time. Okay, next is dependent and independent source. Okay, what is dependent and independent source? If you draw this circuit, in this circuit this voltage source, suppose this is 10 volt battery you have connected. Okay, now this 10 volt battery source is not depending on anything. Okay, if you remove this source, the current flow will be stopped, and if you connect the source, the current will flow like before. So this type of constant source are called dependent source. And what is that? These are called independent source. Okay, because it is not depending on anything. And what is dependent source? Dependent sources are like it is depending on other values that is present in the circuit. Okay, if you want to draw the controlled voltage source, it will be like this. Okay, in square. Okay, plus minus. And if it is controlled current source or dependent current source, it will be like this. Now check this figure. This figure. Okay, here one source is connected, value is 6 ix. One resistor is connected in parallel with that source of value 1 ohm, through which y current is flowing. Okay, now here one constant current source is given, see, 11 ampere. Okay, another resistor is connected here, value of current flowing through is ix. So check that this value, the voltage of this controlled voltage source or dependent source, value is 6 ix. That means this magnitude of the voltage is depending on this ix value. That's why it is called dependent source. Okay, but check this 11 ampere current source or 2 volt voltage source, these are not depending on anything. Is it depending on IY or IX? No, it is independent. These sources are called independent current source and voltage source. Okay, clear? Now next type of connection, it is just the two types of connections are there, you already had studied. Okay, series connection and parallel connection. So what happens in series connection? If this is, this point is A, this is B, and this point is A dash and B dash, Then series connection means the end of one element and the starting of one element is connected together. Okay, it is the main concept of series connection. The end of one element, that means B, and starting of another element. I am saying here element because we can connect R, L, C in series or parallel according to our need. I will show you. Okay. Now here the value is 1 kilo ohm, 2 kilo ohm and 6 kilo ohm. So in series the total equivalent resistance is just the addition of the resistances. Okay. And just a minute. Okay, so the current will flow. Current flowing value is 1 milliampere. So if you multiply and add, the total voltage will be 9 volt. Okay, that means the V1 plus V2 plus V3. Okay. That is the concept of series connection. Next is parallel connection. Parallel connection means all the ends of the elements are connected together and the starting points are connected together. Okay. Check here. All the end points and starting points. All the starting points are connected together and all the end points are connected together. So it is the concept of parallel connection. Okay. So here, what is happening? Here the current value is I1. Here the current value is I2. Current value is, suppose, up to nth resistance. This IN current will flow. Okay. Now, here, what is the value of I1? If the voltage connected here is V, so we have to find the equivalent resistance here.
Now the second part,
we have to connect the voltage source of V, then only one current will flow. Suppose the total current is I, so our equivalent resistance will be V by I. So if you calculate the value of V by I, the value will be the inverse of the R1 inverse plus R2 inverse plus up to Rn inverse, just like it is shown here. Okay, how can you calculate this one? I1 value is V by R1, I2 value is V by R2, because all the resistances are connected in parallel across the same voltage. Okay, across this R1 voltage is V, so current is V by R1. Similarly for R2 it is V by R2. Okay, now what is the total current? I equals to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3 equals to I. So from here you can calculate the equivalent resistance. So we are writing as R equivalent, R eq. Okay, now check this diagram. Here the resistances are connected in series parallel combination, in mixed combination. Okay, so for this example, what is the equivalent resistance value? Can anyone tell me? This value is 8 ohm. This one is 8 ohm. This one is 4 ohm. This one 12 ohm. This one 6 ohm. So what is the equivalent resistance? I want to know this now.
Sir, 12 ohm.
12 ohm. Okay, let me check. 8 plus 4, 12 ohm. 12 parallel. So 6 ohm. 6 plus 6, 12 ohm. Very good. So it is 12 ohm. Okay, so this one is simple. Now, if this kind of connection is given, so you can do it very easily. Okay, and every time check whether the resistances or inductors are connected in what manner. Okay, sometimes in question they may give one inductor is connected, one resistance is connected, like here. Okay, one resistance is also connected here, and one voltage source is connected here. Okay, now what will happen in this circuit when current flows? Suppose this value is L, this is R1, this one is R2, okay, this one is, this voltage is V. Okay, so what will be the current, what will be the current value? Can anyone tell me what will happen? What is the value of current if I connect one ammeter there? Okay, is my question clear to everyone?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay, so please tell me, try to answer this one. I am giving you 30 seconds. Is that enough? Okay, try that. Try this one.
Okay. Now, first of all, we have to delete the value. Because
what will happen?
So, how we delete?
If I try to connect one voltage source and want to calculate the current there, what will happen? Okay, anyone?
Okay. So here, green line.
Okay, fine. So let me tell you. See, number one, the in this inductor is connected across the voltage source, right? So will that inductor work if I connect the inductor across a DC source? Will that work?
No sir.
No. No sir.
What will happen?
No, sir.
It will be just like one short circuit.
Short circuit.
Correct? Okay. So I am redrawing this diagram. Okay. Try to understand. If you cannot, then please let me know. Okay. This is very basic thing. So I am trying to clear your concept. Okay. Okay. This is your L. This is your R. This is your R1. Okay. So, since this one is short circuit, so for a short circuited path, what is resistance? That value is zero. Right?
Yes, sir.
So, yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you do the parallel connection of one 0 ohm resistance with R, so this portion's equivalent resistance will be what? Zero. Right? Because what is the equivalent resistance? R1 into 0 divided by R1. Sorry, this one is R1, this one is R2, right? So R2 in R2 plus 0. Yes. So this one is basically 0. So 0 plus R1. So all total equivalent resistance is R1. So is this that much tough?
No.
Sir. That is basic.
No, sir.
Okay. If this inductor is given, so just remember, if the inductor is connected across any DC voltage source, it will always work as short circuit because the voltage generation is zero across that inductor. Okay. Why? Because rate of change of current is never will happen. That will happen there. Okay, so didt is zero, so voltage across that inductor is always zero.
Zero.
And if you do the parallel connection with this R2 resistance, so all this portion's equivalent resistance will be zero, and zero is connected in series with R1, so the total equivalent resistance is R1. Right. Okay, so what is the value of current? The current value is V by R. Okay, clear? So, we are going to the next part. Series connection, parallel connection of the inductors. Okay, now for inductor, what is the voltage? V1 equals to L di dt, correct? Now here, this L1, L2, L3, all these values are always connected in series, just like the resistor. Okay, why? Because check, V equals to L di dt. Okay, so for first inductor, this will be L1. For second inductor, this will be L2 into di dt. Okay, plus L3 into di dt. Correct? So di dt is constant. Why? Because same rate of change of current will be seen by all the inductors here. So L1 plus L2 plus L3 and in common will be di by dt. So we can write this one as L equivalent into di dt. Okay, so just like the resistor, in series connection, the equivalent inductance will be L1 plus L2 up to Ln if n number of inductors are connected here. Just like the resistance, if these inductors are connected in parallel, this will be your equivalent inductor equation. Okay, next for the capacitor. Now this one is just opposite. Why? Because what is the equation? I equals to C into dV dt. Correct. Now, when it is connected in parallel, what is happening here? When it is connected in parallel, this is your C1, C2. So, here current flowing value is I1, I2 and I3. Okay, now for the C1, we can write as Q equals to C1 into V. Q equals to C2 into V and Q equals to C3 into V. Okay, this will be Q1. This will be Q2, this will be Q3, okay? So total charge is Q and this one will be C1V, C2V and C3V. Now check, the I current values are different, okay? That's why this Q1, Q2, Q3 are written, okay? Now, rather than using this total charge, we can write this one as from Q1 we can write as I equals to CV by T. Okay, this will be I1 C1 into V. For I2 C2 into V by T. Now like this, if you calculate the V by I, you will get this equation C1 plus C2 plus C3 up to Cn. Okay. Also, if you do this total charge concept, also you will get the same formula. Okay. Now, if you connect it like this series connection, then your equation will be like this. 1 by C equals to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3 up to 1 by Cn. So, the connection, according to the connection, the formula is totally opposite with respect to what? The resistors and the inductors. Okay, so don't get confused at any point. okay, with capacitor, inductor and resistor. Because of this equation, the total charge equal to C into V, the whole equation has been changed. Okay. Now, these are the numericals. This is the numerical, okay. So we have very little time left. It is almost 3:47. So this numerical will be solved in next class. Okay. So till now, if you have any query, speak and everyone give your attendance in the chat box. Okay. So thank you everyone. And if you have given your attendance, then you may leave the meeting. Okay. Thank you. And Google Classroom already had been created, and today I will share the link. Okay, everyone, you join there. Okay, assignments, all the study materials, and the list of books from where you have to study these topics will be given there.
Okay, sir, can you tell us the list of books right now?
Okay, okay, I will actually not in a single book. Okay, there are several books, two or three number of books. From there,
yes,
you have to study different topics. Okay, I will tell I will tell in maybe tomorrow in class.
Is that book available on the internet in the PDF file?
Yes, it is available. I will give you the list. Don't worry. Okay.
Sir.
I will
thank
give you today. Okay. Everyone, give your attendance.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, you said, sir, that if a DC source is connected with the inductor, then it will get act as short circuit.
Yes, obviously.
So then if it is, what will be the case when, sir, DC source is connected with capacitor, sir?
Okay, that's a very good question. Okay. You tell me what will happen, then I will give you answer.
Sir,
what
I'm not
is coming in your mind?
Sir. Not getting
okay.
Closer, that's
a fine. You will give the answer. Okay, what is the equation,
sir,
of the capacitor that we are discussing here?
Sir,
I equals to C into dV
into dV by T. Yes, sir.
Correct. So, what is the meaning of dV dt? dV dt means the rate of change of voltage with respect to time.
Yes, sir.
Right. So if you connect one DC voltage source there, then what will happen?
DVDT
value
is zero.
Zero, correct. So if DVDT value is zero, so C into zero means zero.
Zero, yes, sir.
So I value is also zero.
Yes, sir.
Correct. So
yes,
what
sir.
Is
so
the
is the
what is the
what
meaning?
Is the meaning? The current
of
flow across that will be zero.
Okay, just a minute. So your total current flow across that capacitor is zero. So the capacitor will act like one open circuit.
Open circuit.
Right. What is the meaning of current zero? You are trying to flow current, but the current is showing zero. What is the meaning of it? Your connection is not complete. Isn't
yes, sir.
It? So what
yes,
is
sir.
The meaning of current is your circuit is incomplete. That means somewhere
switch,
at
yes,
some point there is open switch, correct. So if you try to connect one capacitor across the DC source,
DC.
So the
yes,
capacitor will act as one open circuit, open connection. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Clear? But unlike
yes.
that, unlike that, if you connect one inductor, that voltage is zero. When the voltage becomes zero, when short circuit occurs.
Yes, sir.
Okay, concept is clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Okay, so if you have given your attendances, you may leave the meeting. Okay?
Thank you.